Lord, I say thank you. Welcome to today's service. Today, the 50th day of December, the last month of this year, 2021. And this week, we'll be doing Psalm 61, Lead Me to the Rock. To the choir master, to be sung with stringed instruments of David. To be sung with stringed instruments, and it is a song of David. Hear my cry, O God, listen to my prayer. From the end of the earth I call to you, when my heart is faint. Lead me to the rock that is higher than I, for you be my refuge, a strong tower against the enemy. Let me dwell in your tent forever. Let me take refuge under the shelter of your wings. For you, O God, have heard my vows. You've given me the heritage of those who fear your name. Prolong the life of a king. May his years endure to all generations. May he be enthroned forever before God. Appoint steadfast love and faithfulness to watch over him. So will I ever sing praises to your name as I perform my vows day after day. This psalm could be considered both an individual lament and a communal lament. It asks for God's help in times of trouble. For we see verses 6 to 7, prolong the life of the king. May his years endure to all generations. May he be enthroned forever before God. Appoint steadfast love and faithfulness to watch over him. Tie royal well-being to the well-being of the whole people. And verse 8 looks forward to acts of public worship as the proper reaction to the help for which the psalm prays. And so verses 1 to 3, as the congregation sees this, they imagine themselves in all kinds of places, the end of the earth, and circumstances. When my heart is faint, in which they feel needy and in danger. In such times, God is a lamb of refuge and strong tower. Verse 4, let me dwell in your tent forever. Let me take refuge under the shelter of your wings. To dwell in God's tent is to be his welcome guest in worship, as you see, and as we saw in Psalm 23, verse 6, and Psalm 27, verse 4, whereby the singer says, what I desire is to dwell in your house forever. And lastly, verses 6 to 7. If God will prolong the life of the king and appoint steadfast love and faithfulness to watch over him, this is then God's people may rest secure in his blessing. And may we also turn to God and enjoy this, as we'll be seeing another reason that Christ suffered and died, to obtain for us all things that are good for us. And again, alongside that, part of those things which are good for us is doing away with our depleted spiritual power by renewing it for his glory. Let us rise and deeply think and take a deep think, reasoning. Let us think and meditate upon the gracious God has enabled us to have.